Hi everyone, I'm Ankur from No Code Talks. Today in this video, I will talk about how you can implement card functionality in the Bumble. How you can implement add to cart, checkout, and make payment, and then you can see the order history and all. So first, let's create first the data thing. So as you all know, data is basically table. Simply, so we are creating one table for the product. This product we have to create a table. So first we create a table with the name of the product. And I'm also not managing any data typing, like privacy thing. So everything is public for right now. So first create a product, just create a title. Tags. Now create a for the price. Number. Yeah, that's it. And price and title. And this video is for the like very dummy. I'm just not adding a multiple description or pretty basic. Price and title. And then one more thing. One more type, that is item card. So whatever the so it will have a product that is product type, that is number of quantity that user purchase, quantity of this number create, and yes, that's it. And we add this into the user. So add the user is product cart. Just add the item. Okay, we have forget one thing. We have to add a multiple. Item product, that is product. Sorry, that user will have a list of cart. That is item simply item card would have item card that to our list of card. Yeah, that's it. And item card have one more thing, that is final cost. So final cost is something number of product into product quantity into price. So that is final cost will be the product price into quantity. So it will always have a like updated value. So yeah, we have set up a DB. So what we have done, we have just created one product table that will have a price and title. And then we have item card. Item card will have a like a product detail, its final cost and quantity user purchased. Third is we are saving all this in the user card. So that is item card. So that is our list of cart that will have a current cart with the user. So first go into app data, just add the product, like random product. So that is product one, hide it, product two, 30. We will add a 5 product. $4.99 product. Product 5. $1.99. Yeah. All is done. And then, yeah. Now we'll come on the design. So just we put a repeating group to show the all the product available. So I'm not managing all the, and that is pretty basic. So we'll just keep a tag for the title. One is for the pricing thing. And that input for the number of quantity user want to purchase. User can purchase anything. So we will just okay. It will have a okay. We have to pass the, so we will pass the all the product to search for the list of all the product, no constant, and just make it full list. So it will be a vertical full list. Just pass it to current user product and title. This will be current user product price, and just move it to here. Yeah. Now this is quantity. User need to enter it. And now there will be one more button that is for add to cart. So whenever user click on add to cart, it will add to the user cart. Make it add. So we will just create a one workflow. What is our workflow? We have to first create an item cart. So how you will create? Just create new things. Just item cart. Set the field. First pineapple, first product, and third is quantity. So quantity will be input. Input quantity value. Product will be whatever the current product value. Okay, it is evaluated as a tax. So just change, go to there and change it to integer. Now it will fix quantity. Okay, let's move it to. Oh, we just got wrong. We have to pass the quantity. The quantity. Now the final cost. Final cost will be product price into input quantity value. That's it. So it will be like final cost will be current product price into number of quantities that user want to purchase it. Just you add it, yeah, and then so there is item cart. Now all the whatever user product user add into cart, it will add into the add to item cart table. So all the product will be added here, this table item. Now we have to add this into respective user. So what we are just doing, just go current, make changes to the current user, select the cart field, just add the current product. Sorry, result of this item. So what we are doing right now, whatever the product user want to purchase, we are storing that in the item cart table, and then we are storing or adding that particular product along with number of purchase quantity into the cart, user cart. So if his user is logged in, user will see its cart. If user not logged in, user will not see it. That's it, basically. Add to cart is done. Now we will create one cart. So for the cart, just put a tag something. Just final cart. Just make it dark. I'm just taking randomly. Okay, just little bit. Now here will be the same. Repeating group will be there. So look here. We are using item cart type of the content, but the source of the content is data current user cart. So it is the source, not the item cart value. It is not source. We are just using item cart table as a like a temp table or temporary table to store the data. That's it. Now come the tags. It will be something random. Okay, we have to just, yeah. It will be random. Current is the cart title, product title. So copy it, paste it. It will be final cost of this particular product, and then it will be quantity, user number of quantity user purchased. Let's copy one more. It will be price, final cost. Just to give him, just put a dollar here, just to represent the price. Okay, just put a dollar and the input current product price. It will give this is done. So it will now we have to calculate the final cost. That is the final cost. What will the final cost? That's pretty simple. Just make it change it to that's too dark. And one more thing, that is output, that how you calculate the final cost. It's pretty simple. Go to card user, card, final amount, and its sum. That's it. That will be a final. We also put a dollar sign. Correct. Dollar sign there. Go to the insert card, current user, card, final cost, and sum. Put all this into the one group. So that is properly aligned. Okay, first we have to put this into the one part. One group. Put this into the group. So it properly. Now we have to put a one more button to make a payment. So make it this. Make payment. That's it. When you summon. Yeah, now the interesting thing. So I'm not adding any payment integration or payment gateway. I'm just manually triggering order. So first we have to create an order table. Just go to data types, order. So order will have a list of all the item card or all the product. Whoever user purchase, that will have a list. So just list order value for the total order value number. Next one is order number, most important. Number. So how we will do that? So just click over this. Start an edit flow and now go to the create a new thing. So we will create an order. So item card will have a set, do current user all the cart value. And now the order number. Order number will be the, we are just using a basic thing, do search for all the orders and last item. Order number. So it will be like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Initially there is no table, so it will return 0 and then we just add up plus 1, order number and plus 1. Hope everything is clear till now. If you have any question or something, just comment it out. I will be happy to answer your or your queries. So let's learn together. Order value, total value is current user, card, final product, sum. So there's one interesting thing I just tell you, checking, never copy the value from, so whenever you are dealing with the money thing, so never copy value from one position to another, always calculate. Because it happened, a very simple hacking is when you run this and just click on the right click on inspect them, you can change the whatever the value is visible to the user. So it's better user you always calculate the value and then just delete the empty the cart clearly, just clear it. Now we will check. Everything is working, not working, whatever. Yes, let me just move it here. So now you just had to quantity, like for example, 78, sorry, 2. Add to cart, do 20. If this is the final cost. Now we will add a product 2, 8, 240. Now we will add product 3, 10. That's it. Now you will check the final cost. Final cost is 1260. Is it $1,000? 240? Yeah, it is. It is there. So now make payment. So cart is automatically clear, and one order is available added in the database. Let's check it that out. Go to the data. Go to app data and orders. This is. One caveat is there, never delete this table, never. If you delete this table, all your order reference will be deleted. Yeah. Hope I cleared your all the doubt related to cart functionality. So let me know how you like it or not. So whatever your feedback and everything, share in the comment section. I am happy to answer. Thank you very much. Thank you.